Good morning, children. You know that we have been studying arithmetic progression or AP. We have also defined what is AP and list of few examples also given. Today, from 2 days when we are observing, we came to know that you have certain doubts. Today we are going to clear doubts in the form of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Arithmetic progression, you know that, let me revise once again. Arithmetic progression is nothing but a list of numbers in which the difference between any two consecutive numbers remains constant. So based on this, we have experimented also. Just by looking at certain set of numbers, we must have to say whether it is arithmetic progression or not. To say that whether the set of number is arithmetic progression or not, what we need to know is common difference. Common difference, that is D. Only the D is a matter. If we have a common difference between the consecutive numbers, then we can say that is arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression is that's all. Each consecutive number should have common difference. So you got the meaning of that. The arithmetic progression means should have the common difference. Just by seeing the set of number, we should know that whether if they have common difference, then it is arithmetic progression. That's all it is. Arithmetic progression means they should have common difference. Okay. And I also told you that how to apply the arithmetic progression in your life. Every day, for example, from today on, 1 year is 365 days are there. In 365 days, from today on, count 365 days, and today you learn one word, tomorrow two, next day three, like this. If you keep on learning each word, by 365, at the end of 365 days, how many words you can learn, that could be predicted using arithmetic progression, that you have to do. And also said that per day, how many hours you sleep. So based on that, how many hours you live. Sorry, how many years you live. That means if you say 80 years if you are living, then 365 into 80, if you multiply, you will get certain number of days. In that number of days, how many hours you have slept, using you knowing that and using arithmetic progression, you can solve the problem. That means to say that how many hours in your 80 years of life you have slept, all those calculations. Not only that, if you are saving money also, how to in a year or 2 year, how much will you save at the end of the year or at the end of 2 years, how much of money you will be having, all those things you can predict by using arithmetic progression. All those things you can do that by applying that, you will come to know the real meaning of what is arithmetic progression. Now, arithmetic progression problem we have given you to check whether they are arithmetic progression, whether the set of numbers are arithmetic progression or not. You have sent these problems that you don't know how to do. You have doubts in this problem. To solve these problems, you should know first what is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. See children, there are four operations in the mathematics: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. You must know that addition and subtraction falls under one category. Multiplication and division falls under another category. So if you know the perfect meaning of what is addition, subtraction, what is multiplication, division, then you can easily solve all the problems. Now let me explain what is addition. Addition is nothing but, you know that you have two forms, plus, plus, minus, all these things are there. So addition, for example, if you are given a number 2, should be added with number 2. Okay? So when we say only number 2, then this number is nothing but plus 2. Then this number is also plus 2. If only one number is considered, when signs are not given, you should think that is plus 2. How many plus 2's are there? There are plus, 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 plus. There are 4 plus. So we will say that 4 plus. Means to say that any plus comes, you have to add. Any minus comes, for example, 2 minus 2. What is 2 minus 2? Mostly what you children do is, 2 minus appears, means minus into minus, plus you will make. No. Minus and minus is minus itself. 2 and 2. So this is how you have to calculate. For example, 3 plus 5 is there. 3 plus 5 is nothing but plus 3 plus 5. Plus 3 plus 5 is plus 8. Minus 3 minus 5. So minus minus remains minus only. And 5 plus 3 is nothing but 8. So when 2 plus signs comes, you have to add. When 2 minus sign comes also, you must add. You should know that. Just by seeing that 2 minus are there, you cannot make minus into minus plus. Why? Because in addition, multiplication and division, see, these are the signs will be there for multiplication. Bracket, dot and cross. If bracket, dot and cross are there, then this refers to you have to multiply. How you multiply? For example, same thing. You can see that 2 and minus 2 and minus 2 is nothing but minus 4. We have not multiplied here because there is no bracket or dot or cross. Now the same problem, minus 2 dot minus 2 is equals to. Now comes here the dot or minus 2 bracket minus 2 or minus 2 cross minus 2. All these things are multiplication itself. Here what you are going to do is minus, since it is a multiplication sign, minus into minus is plus. 2 into 2 is the same way here also. As you have a bracket, bracket refers to multiplication. Minus into minus is plus. 2 into 2 is 4. Same here, cross. Cross is also multiplication sign. Minus into minus plus 2 into 2. In all this case you will get like this, but not in this case. Why? Because here you can see that there is no multiplication sign at all. So you are not doing any multiplication. Minus minus should be added. Plus plus should be added. Here minus minus is there. There is no multiplication sign. What you are going to do is minus 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 2. 2 and 2 is nothing but 4. So this is how you have to do. So few more examples you will give. For example, 7 plus 5. 7 plus 5 is nothing but, you know that what is this 7? This 7 is nothing but plus 7, plus 5. Plus plus becomes, is there any multiplication sign here? Since there is no multiplication sign, plus plus is nothing but plus itself, then 7 plus 5 is nothing but. Now you can see that 7 minus 7 minus 5. Minus 7 minus 5, minus minus remains minus only because there is no multiplication sign. Again, 7 plus 5 is nothing but minus. The same thing we do here, 7 into 5. 7 into 5 is nothing but plus 7 plus 5. Plus into plus is plus 6, 7, 5 is 5. Now you can see 7 minus 7 into minus 5 is equals to minus into minus plus 7, 5 is 5. Now 1 minus and 1 plus, then minus into plus is nothing but minus 7 times. This is how you have to see the signs and then you have to decide whether they are addition or subtraction or multiplication or division. If it is addition, then there will not be any signs of this. If it is subtraction, then 1 plus 1 minus comes. 1 plus 1 minus only becomes a subtraction. That limit will explain later. All the plus should be added. All the minus should be added. When it comes to multiplication, minus into minus is plus. Plus into plus is plus itself. Understood, children?